So I'm going to go pretty quickly. So I just came back from the Consumer Electronics Show. 140,000 people, 2,700 exhibits, about 25 kilometers of aisles of walking over 5 days. And so I brought it down to one bag and a few extra things. So I'm going to give you a quick overview of some of the fun things that I found here. As some of you may know, I'm co-founder of GadgetOff. Dan Dubnow, some of you may know, is my partner in this. And we bring the smart and the useless together, that's what we say. This is more probably the smart than the useless, but I'll let you decide what might be useless. But anyway, this year, most people talked about the Consumer Electronics Show, and they said it was the year of the tablet. This was the whole big thing. Tablets came in all sizes, from 3-inch to 5-inch to Kindles, to, of course, the iPad. And then people ask me what I carry all the time. And, of course, it's the Galaxy Tab. Not because it's the best one, but because it fits in my pocket. And so, therefore, the one you have with you is the best one. But those are not new. You've seen those already. What is new, though, is this device here. This is the No, and this is a prototype of a digital textbook. And basically, the idea is this is for students to use. And it is a fairly large device, dual screen. You see a lot of dual screen tablets. You have a pen with it. So with the pen, you can do things like you can underline. Just put the pen on here. You can draw circles around things. You can underline. You can doodle just like you want. You can put stickies on it. This is the digital textbook that some people think is the future of digital learning. Now, this is a prototype. It's very heavy, but it's a very interesting product, and I think you should be taking a look at this, and along with the other tablets coming down. Now, of course, tablets were only one part of the story at CES this year. The second part of the story was 3D. Everything was in 3D. And so in my bag of tricks here, you can see I have a few toys. It's always fun to get through security at the airport with this. But anyway, so 3D, we all knew, were, you know, these crazy glasses. And this is called Anaglyph. And quite frankly, it's a pretty awful experience. Of course, what's happened is we've gone to new techniques in 3D with the glasses you get from the movie theater. You're all familiar with this. But where's the 3D content going to come from? There's not a lot of 3D content. Yes, you can have it at the movies. Yes, there are some Blu-rays, but there really are about a dozen of them. They're not very many. So the answer has been 3D for yourself, 3D at home. So I have a few products here. This is the Fuji. It's a 3D still camera. It has two lenses, as you can see here. It takes 3D pictures. I will take a picture of you all here. And it's what they call auto stereoscopic, which means that you can look at the back of this without glasses. Unfortunately, only one person at a time. So this is a still camera. Right next to that, of course, if you really want to be 3D with your friends, this is a 3D webcam. This will go on top of your camera and you on your TV, on your computer, and you can do a 3D webcam. Again, the two cameras. There's even a 3D flip cam. You know, little thing like this comes down here, has the capability of having the ability to quickly create your own videos. Again, two lenses, 3D flip cam. Of course, there's 3D camcorders. So here is a little 3D camcorder. Again, two little lenses. So these are the low-cost ones. By the way, this device here is about $150. This is under $100. This is about $300. Again, auto-stereoscopic. But that's not where the really exciting things are happening. Panasonic and Sony showed 3D camcorders. Now, the Sony one's not available yet. Sony, you know, stands for soon, only not yet. So it's not there yet. But Panasonic is here. This is a 3D camera. It is a three-chip camera, so it's a camcorder, so it's a fairly decent quality camcorder, full 1080, and this is a 3D lens on it, and it will shoot 3D. But even more fun is this is the new GH2 camera. Some of you may be familiar with the G1. There's a GH1, and now there's a G2, and it's got an interchangeable lens camera. This is part of the new mirrorless cameras. You can take this lens off, though. That's one nice thing about it. And you can put this lens on here, and now I have a 3D single lens reflex camera. So I've just put a 3D lens on this so you can create your own content. Now, 3D, of course, some most of it, this, the secondary things I just showed, you really do need glasses. And so in the movie theater at home, what you're using are active shutter glasses. These are active shutter glasses. But if you go to the movie theater, you really would like to see something a little bit better. These are awful. They're plastic. There are no lenses. But what's happening is some people are now coming out with designer glasses. These are real glass, real glasses that really have high quality. They're more expensive. But if you want to go and enjoy a movie in its full quality, I'd highly recommend you get yourself a pair of these glasses. The company, this is Cyphrex company. These are real optical folks, and this is a really nice 3D experience. It even has little lenses on the side, so if you're watching it in IMAX, you can see what's going on. Now, of course, when we talk about cameras, they're not just 3D. So one of the things I found fun was this little device here. It's a very simple. Don't worry about this. This is the amount. But here is a little tripod, very lightweight. You can take it out, and it sets itself up like a tent, so it goes on here. Now you'd say, okay, that's kind of fun, but why would I want to do that? Well, I have here a little camera that can be added to this device here. I turn it on, and I turn this on, and this is a robotic camera, and as you can see, the camera is going to start to look around the room. Now, this is using face detection. It's going to look around, look for a face, use a smile detection. When it finds a picture it wants to take of somebody, it will take your picture. Leave this at a party. It's great fun. Just let it sit somewhere and just set it all night long. It'll just take pictures randomly, and it'll sit there and work away. Now, of course, other people are looking for an ability to enjoy. They want to shoot things, and they're on a, for example, they might be on a roller coaster or something. And somebody said, "Wouldn't it be cool if I could have a system where, in fact, what's happening here is I have a camera that shoots forward." So there's a camera shooting forward, and there's a screen in the back. But there's a second camera on the back. So when you're taking a picture of yourself running around on the roller coaster or something, you can also get your reaction. It puts a window on here, so you get two pictures of yourself as you're shooting. Anyway, kind of crazy fun. And of course, if you want to have a point of view, you can always use this little device here, which is an over-the-ear camera, and it Bluetooths to your cell phone, so you can do live streaming as you are enjoying yourself running around. Now, of course, running around, there's something, some people like to do things outside. And when you do things outside, out here, I noticed it's been near, we went through the Alps when we came down here. So I had this little device here, which is kind of interesting. This is a ski mask. It's a very actually good ski mask. Now, the interesting about this ski mask is it actually, if you look here, it's actually lit up. And the reason it's lit up is because this is an active ski mask. Now, what is an active ski mask? Well, the first thing is, inside here, it's hard for you to see it, but inside here, there's an OLED display, a heads-up display. There's a GPS receiver in this mask, so as you're going down the mountain, it will be tracking all your altitude, your speed, the temperature, and all other things, giving you a display as you're going down the mountain or anywhere else you might be driving. So this is kind of interesting. But of course, that is your experience, and how would you like, you want to share that with somebody else. I have another device, which is this camera here. This is the Contour GPS camera, and it will sit on here on your helmet or whatever you want to do. This is a full HD camera. Now, notice there's a blue light flashing here. That's because it's Bluetooth connected, so I can actually set up the camera with my iPad Touch here. So I've got all the controls here. I can even look at it as I'm going. Now, you'll say, okay, that's cool, a camera, but there's one more trick to this. This also has GPS. So when you play this back, it has metadata that goes with it. So as you're going back, you can actually see a track of where you've been with your camera, whether you're going down the mountain. So not only can you experience it in your headset, in your goggles, but you can also, when you come home, see the whole thing coming out. Now, when you're out in the middle of nowhere in your mountains, it's kind of nice to know that if you get stuck somewhere, you may want to send in a message. This is the Spot GPS. Now, spot GPS, so three GPS devices on me. This one, though, is a little bit different because this receives GPS like everything else, but the other thing it does is it also transmits a signal back. So there's an emergency button here. I can press this. So no matter where I am in the world, this will actually transmit up the satellite, send a GPS message and say, we have a problem or whatever, or I can just check in and say, I'm fine. Now, of course, if you don't traveling in the in the snow and all the rest, you can also, if you like the summer, here's an iPod case or any phone case. It happens to have a Windows mobile phone in it right now. But what's interesting about this, it's waterproof, but it has a little buoy. If this goes in the water, this buoy explodes, brings this thing out to the surface, and puts a nice big orange spot on the water so you can find this again. So these are some things. Of course, if you're also doing this and you want to know how fast you're going, I have a radar gun. It's a portable radar gun. Same thing the police use. I can track the other people out skiing or whatever and get their exact speeds. So there are a lot of toys. Now, I said smart and the useless. So there are always some things that are kind of interesting. This is a meat thermometer. You stick it in your meat for the barbecue. It's called the iGrill. And notice, again, same thing, it has a blue light flashing. Why is there a blue light flashing? Well, it is a Bluetooth phone, of course. So this will go to your iPhone or your iPad, and you can go over to your device, and you can go in here, and with iGrill, it will give you your timer and your temperature, and you can put in your recipes, and it will sit there and alert you. Now, you can do it I put it on the iPad so you can see it, but of course, it'll go on your iPhone as well. So you can leave this cooking and run around, and if you're watching the game and you're worried about not having any information, it'll automatically send it to you. Now, I have enough stuff here to go for probably another few minutes. So I'm going to go really quickly because I'm running out of time. This is an interesting device. This goes into the universal port in your car. You plug this into your car. It transmits all the car data. So all cars made since 1987 have one of these. You stuck it in here, and it transmits via Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, depending on the model you get, to your smartphone. It tells you all the car parameters. So when you see something that says, for example, check engine light is on, all the rest, you can see this. And, in fact, with the right software, you can actually go and adjust things. It's a lot of fun. But that's not all. There's some crazy things. I promised some crazy things. So here's a crazy thing. This is an iPod case. Now, you know there's iBeer and other things like that, applications. Well, this is a practical thing. It actually has a bottle opener on the bottom, so you can actually open your bottle. And because it is also designed for drinking, not only will you have the iBeer thing, but there's a breath analyzer. You see, you blow into this here, and it will tell you whether you're drunk and whether you can open it up. Now, power, of course, is something that's very important everywhere. So this is a flashlight. It's very, very light. It runs, it's a LED flashlight. But what's interesting is there are no batteries in here. This runs an ultra capacitor. And this device here, I tell you, when I went to security, I was afraid about this. This is a kinetic energy generator. You stick this in your pants or your backpack, and as you move up and down, this generates electricity. It stores in the battery. It's also magnetic, which was causing some interesting problems as I was running around. But when I'm looking for applications that are fun and all the rest, there is one that is my favorite, and it is a little device that I've been having a lot of fun with here. And I'm going to move this out of the way here because this might be a problem. Take a picture of it all here. This is an iPad application, and you can see that the clock says I have zero time. Since I have zero time, I better get going quickly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take off. Well, not literally take off. I'll get off the stage. Before I do that, I'm going to hit the button that says take off here, and very quickly, my little camera will fly up here, and we can now have a flying camera, and as you can see, there you guys are in my flying camera. So these are some things that are kind of fun, and I enjoy this. I won't fly it around the audience a little bit. I'm a good pilot, but not that good. And when there's a lot of downdraft or there's an air conditioning unit, sometimes I have more problems than others. But there you guys are, enjoying yourselves in my camera. Oh, by the way, it also has a downward-looking camera, so I can see what the floor looks like, so I know how to land. So I guess I better land this thing. There you go. Thank you very much.